All right, we're going to move on. More than 2 years after 19 children and two teachers were gunned down at Robb Elementary in Uvalde, Texas, a grand jury announcing criminal charges against former Uvalde School District Police Chief Pete Arredondo. This marking the first criminal charges against law enforcement for what is widely viewed as a botched police response to the horrific massacre in May of 2022. The sheriff confirming to ABC News that Arredondo was released from custody after being booked into the Uvalde County Jail on charges of abandoning and endangering a child. ABC's Jacqueline Lee is following this story and joins us now. Jacqueline, a lot of people have been waiting to hear this kind of news. Break down what these charges are and why we're seeing them now.
Yeah, that's right, Phil. So Arredondo, he's facing 10 counts of abandoning and endangering a child. The 10 counts are for the 10 Robb Elementary School survivors. Now, the indictment says he intentionally, knowingly, recklessly, and with criminal negligence placed a child younger than 15 in imminent danger of bodily injury, death, and physical and mental impairment. Now, the indictment, it lays out all the details. For example, after hearing shots fired in a room at Robb Elementary, he failed to respond as trained and instead called SWAT, which delayed the response. Another example, after hearing shots fired and was told that a teacher was shot, he failed to call an active shooter incident. Now, in a recorded interview with investigators the day after, Arredondo said he did not view himself as the incident commander, which contradicts the active shooter plan that he created. And of course, the other person indicted is Adrian Gonzalez. He is a former member of the school police force, and he hung up when a reporter asked him for comment, Phil.
Jacqueline, I was out there covering this when it happened. It still is so incredibly difficult to watch that video now that we know what happened and what didn't happen. This is a moment so many families in that area have been waiting for, families of the victims, families of the survivors. How are they reacting?
That's right, Phil. So, you know, families say they're glad charges are filed, but of course they're wondering, with nearly 400 law enforcement officers responding, will they face charges? So take a listen.
I'm happy, but at the same time, it's like this is just the first step that needs to be done. It's been 2 years, 1 month and 4 days, and we're barely seeing anything. But I'm also worried that the DA is just going to leave it at this, just those two, when we saw 376 officers arrive.
There is concern among parents that will this go to trial? If it does, can the children take it, Phil?
All right, Jacqueline, thanks so much. Appreciate it.